Because of original sin, God sees us as totally corrupted. Not in the moral sense, since most people still act good most of the time, but in the image and likeness spiritual sense. When we stop thinking we were God's children and even fought against the idea of being His, we became totally wicked and evil in His sight instead of righteous. When God gave us Christ, He gave us something far greater than anything Satan took away from us when he deceived us. God may not be a man, but he is definitely masculine. The devil does not want us to have dominion over the earth, because he cannot stand to see us be successful at something he was unable to accomplish. Christians believe Satan fell because he refused to bow down to God, while Muslims believe he fell because he refused to bow down to man. Which seems kind of ironic for a religion that prides itself on being submissive to God. My joy will be complete if the whole world, after reading this, comes together in fellowship with me and the Father. To teach Christ, you must know Christ. This way you will not be just another man teaching others about the Lord Jesus, but an anointed disciple of His who is teaching. And then it will not be your teachings, but His teachings, because He will be within you. Every time you proclaim the name Jesus, you are declaring that God saves and that He has saved you from your sins through Jesus. Some people think that because I say I'm Jesus, that I should know everything. Nowhere in the Bible does Jesus say He knew everything about everything. And at times He even said that there were things that only His Father knew. I know that as the head of the church, I have been given authority over every throne, power, ruler, and authority. And that all peoples, nations, and men of every language shall worship me. But even with all this dominion and supremacy, I will not forget where I came from. My greatest desire is the salvation of all men. The author of life died so you could live. Even those who do not believe or follow Jesus have been secretly watching and waiting to see if He shows up because of the commanding presence He has made on the history of the world. Do not let this opportunity pass you by to prove to them you were right. My novel interpretation of the Bible should prove enlightening to most of you. A prophet should not perish away from Jerusalem. Therefore, Koresh's death has extended Jerusalem's reach to to the other side of the world. The church is only the beginning of God's kingdom on earth. God intends for his kingdom to eventually reign over every facet of our life. You fulfill the law by keeping every detail of it. It is not fulfilled in the sense that it is completed and therefore done away with in that sense. It is better for the king to die for all than for all to perish because of the king. I am not saying this about my own self, since I have already laid down my life once for you, but as a power to be used to keep in check any further king so that the children of God are not scattered again. If you will read the passage again that talks about submitting to those in authority, you will see that it is really talking about submitting to those who are put in charge during the judgment and wrath, to collect what is owed God for our disobedience. It is not an endorsement for keeping and supporting a secular world. Obeying your heavenly Father trumps obeying your earthly parents. Honoring your father and mother while you are here on earth should never interfere with the work God has commanded you to do for him. Jesus is Lord. I don't ever want to be accused of trying to deceive you, so I would prefer you come into this with your eyes wide open, rather than blindly submitting to whatever I say. As long as your nation keeps trying to put shackles on me in an attempt to control me, I'm going to keep trying to destroy it. Bowing down to God should be because you want to, but I will force you if I have to. I'm not going to force my way on you, but I am going to require that you honor our desire to separate from you. The only recourse most of you will have against a world that has continually taken from you your whole life is to gather up every resource you can and bring it with you when you enter the kingdom of God. Jesus is the fullness of the deity's divine plan in bodily form. It is the same plan he has for each and every one of us who will accept it.